Dear student, good morning to all. I welcome you for the online class. In this class, we see about chapter 6, division. I hope you are all completed the previous day homework. Do your homework regularly. So, in this class, we see about problem based on real life situation. Okay. So, see that one. Self-practice 6A. 6 to sum. 20 wheels, 4 wheels on each car. How many cars? Okay, so what do you understand from the question? So in the totally how many wheels are there? 20 wheels are there. So it is given as 20 wheels, 4 wheels on each car. So one car contains 4 wheels. So you have to find how many cars the 20 wheels are fixed. Okay, that one you have to find. So how will you do that sum? So first you have to divide the total wheel divided by number of wheels on each car. So total wheel how much? 20. So 20 divide one car contain how many wheels? 4. So 20 divided by 4. 20 divided by 4. So this is the short method. You have to divide that one. So what in this sum, which one is dividend? 20 is dividend. 4 is called divisor. So here, so you have to write this one as division method. So 20 divided by 4. So you have to write the 4 table at the side. 1 4 is 4, 2 4 is 8, 3 4 is 12, 4 4 is 16, 5 4 is 20. So how many times you multiply 4, you get 20? 5 times. So you multiply 4 by 5, you get 20 as your answer. So totally 4, 5 is 20. That one you have to write it as quotient. This is a short method of division. In the next we see about the long division. So 4, 5 are 20. So your answer will be correct. So your answer is 5 car. What's the quotient here? That is your answer. So what's the quotient? 5. So your answer is 5 car. So the 5 cars contain 20 wheels. Okay. See the next one. 15 chocolate, 5 for each girl. How many girls? So what do you understand? Totally, how many chocolates? 15 chocolates are there. How many girls are there? You have to find the number of girls. So, for each girl, they distribute 5 for each girls. So, one girl contains 5 chocolates. So, how many girls will be shared the chocolate, 15 chocolates? So, you have to write the answer. Total chocolate divided by number of chocolates for each girl. So, total chocolate 15. Divided by number of chocolate for each girl equal to 5. So 15 divided by 5. So which one is the dividend? 15 is the dividend and 5 is the divisor. What is the divisor here? You have to write that table at the side. So you at the side you have to write 5 table. In the 5 table you check where you get 15 as the answer. So 3 5s are 15. So 3 girls will share the 15 chocolate. So you have to write the quotient as 3. So 15 divided by 5 equal to 3. So your answer is 3 girls. Okay, are you understand? So you see the next one. 8th one, 35 books, 7 books on each shelf. How many shelves? So what do you understand? 35 books are there. Out of this 35, 7 books in each shelf. Which shelf means? One shelf. In one shelf, 7 books are arranged. In how many shelves the total book 75 is arranged? That is a question. Okay. So first you have to write total number of books. Total number of books 75. Number of books in one shelf is 7. So 35 divided by 7. So in this one, which one is the dividend? 35 is the dividend and 7 is the divisor. So you have to write the division 35 divided by 7. So you have to write the 7 table at the side. In that 7 table, you check whether you, in which in how many times you multiply 7 you get 35. So you have to multiply 5 times 7 you get 35. So the 5 is the answer. So you have to write 5 as a quotient. So 7 5s are 35. So answer is 5 cells. In 5 cells the 35 books are arranged. This is the method of doing the sums. Next one we see about division with remainder. Division with remainder. See that one first one. This is self-practice 6F. First one, 6 58 divided by 6. That one you have to write in the division form. 58 divided by 6. In this 58 divided by 6, which one is the dividend? 58. The biggest the number present inside that division mark is there, no? So that one is the dividend. The number which present outside of that division mark is called divisor. So 58 is the dividend and 6 is the divisor. Now you have to divide using the multiplication table. So at the side you have to write the 6 table. So now how will you divide? First you have to see the first digit of the dividend and the divisor. You have to compare first digit of the dividend and the divisor number. What is the first digit of the dividend? In the first digit is 5. Divisor 6. Whether 5 is less than 6 or greater than 6? 5 is less than 6. If the first digit is less than the divisor, then you have to take 2 digit. Okay. Are you understand? First you have to compare the first digit of the dividend and the divisor, whether it is greater than or less than. Now in the sum, the first digit is less than the divisor. So it is not divide. So you have to take 2 digits. So 2 digits mean only 2 digits are there. Suppose in this question 3 digit, 4 digit, like that mean how to take this next digit. So next, if you take the next digit mean your answer is 58. If 58 is greater than 6. Okay. So now you have to check the 6 table. In 6 table, in which place the number 58 will come. So see that one in 6 table. 58 is not come. Okay. So you have to check the number below 58 or nearest to 58. Okay. Which one is nearest to 58? 54. Okay. Less than means all the numbers 6, 12, 18, everything, all the numbers are less than 58 only. But nearest to 58 is 54 only. Okay. So 9 and 6 are 54. If you multiply 6, 9 times, you get the answer 54. Okay. So you have to underline this one. So 6, 9. So you have to take this number only. You didn't take greatest number. 10, 6 are 60. You have only 58. So you have to leave that one. You have to take the nearest divisor. That is 54. So 9 and 6 are 54. You have to write that 9 as a quotient. You compare and take 2 digit only now. So you have to write the quotient above the second digit only. Okay, you have to write the 9 here to 8. Okay, 9 6 are 54. Now, below the dividend, you have to write the answer 54. Now you have to subtract these two numbers, 58 minus 54. So as usual, normal subtraction. 8 minus 4, 4. 5 minus 5, 0. You no need to write 0. In the first sum, I wrote 0. Okay. So, 8 minus 4, 4 only. So, this is called method of doing long division. In the previous sum, we see short division only. Only how to write the number of times only. No need to subtract at all. You got the exact answer. But in this one, you got remainder. Okay. So, if you got remainder, mean you have to do it only in the long division method. So, 9, 6 are 54. 58 minus 54, 4 only. Now you have to write the quotient and remainder for the sums. So this is called quotient, and how many numbers after subtraction, what number you got, that is the remainder. So remainder equal to 4. So quotient 9, remainder 4. In the it will be write in short form. 58 divided by 6 equal to, first you have to write the quotient. Then for remainder, you have to mention it as R. How many remainders are there? 4. So 9 R 4. This is the short method. If you need, you have to write. Otherwise, you didn't write. Simply, you have to write quotient 9, remainder 4. That's all. It is enough for you. Okay. So in your book, it will be wrote in this method. So 9 quotient. For remainder, you have to mention it as R. And then you have to write the remainder number. So 9 R 4. Okay, 58. Finally, you wrote 58 divided by 6 equal to 9 or 4. Okay, are you understand? Next, see the next sum. 74 divided by 9. 74 divided by 9. Now, which one is the dividend? 74 is the dividend and 9 is the divisor. First, what do you have to do? Anyone? Very good. First, you have to compare the first digit and the divisor. In your divide, you have to compare the first digit of the dividend and the divisor. What is the first digit of the dividend? 7. Okay. 7. Now you have to compare 9 and 7. 9 is which one is greatest? Divisor is greater than first digit of the dividend. So if the first digit is less than the divisor, what you have to do? How to take 2 digits. So you take 2 digits. If you take 2 digits, mean what's the number? 74. At the side of the sum, how to write the 9 table. Okay. So you wrote 9 table at the side. Now see, 74 will be come as answer in your table, 9 table? No. So next you have to, what you have to do? How to see the nearest number for the dividend. Which is the nearest number for the dividend? 72 is the nearest number to 74. Okay. So how many times you multiply 9 get 72? 8 times. So 8 9s are 72. So that 8 you have to write at the top. Okay. That one is called quotient. Now you have to subtract these two numbers. 74 minus 72. 74 minus 72. 4 minus 2, what's your answer? 4 minus 2? 4 minus 2, 2. 4 minus 2, 2. Then 7 minus 7, 0. No need to write that 0. So leave them. So from in this sum, which is the quotient? Quotient is 8 and remainder is 2. So how to write it as 8 or 2? First you have to write the quotient. Then for remainder, you have to write R and remainder 2. Then write the number. Finally, you wrote 74 divided by 9 equal to 8 or 2. Okay. This is the method of doing long division. I hope you are all understand. Next, we see about the next sum. Now, see the next sum. 69 divided by 8. 69 divided by 8. In this sum, which one is dividend? Very good. 69 is the dividend and divisor 8. Okay. So, you have to, for your identification only, I will wrote here. So, 69 dividend 8 divisor. Next, what you have to do? Very good. You have to compare the first digit and the divisor. First digit and the divisor. What is the first digit? 6 is the first digit of the dividend and 8 is divisor. Whether it is less than or greater than? 6 is less than 8. So, next what you have to do? You have to take 2 digit in the dividend. If you take 2 digit, mean what's the number? 69. Now, see the 8 table. Whether 69 came in the 8 table or not. 69 didn't come. So, you have to compare and see the nearest number to, nearest to 69. So, 64, see that one, which one is nearest to 69? 64 is nearest to 69. So, how many times if you multiply 8, we get 64? 8 times. If you multiply 8 by 8 times, we get 64. So, 8 8s are 64. So, you have to write the 8 as quotient. And that answer below the dividend. So 69 minus 64. Now we have to subtract these two numbers. So 9 minus 4. 9 minus 4. What's your answer here? You have to write the subtraction symbol. Here you have to write the subtraction symbol. So 69 minus 64. So 9 minus 4, 5. 6 minus 6, 0. 1. No need to write the 0. Okay. So 5 is the remainder. Now you have to write the quotient and remainder for the sum. So quotient equal to 8 and remainder 5. So in the short form you have to write 69 divided by 8 equal to 8 or 5. Okay. First you have to write the quotient, then for remainder you have to write R, then write the remainder number 5. Okay. Then see the next sum. 56 divided by 7. 56 divided by 7. So in this one, which is the dividend? 56 is the dividend and 7 is the divisor. Same method. First you have to compare the first digit of the dividend and the divisor. So the first digit is less than the divisor. So you have to take 2 digit, 56. So now you have to see the number 56 in your table, 7 table. So you got 56? Yes. In this one, you got exact 56 in your table. So how many times multiply 7? 8 times. So 8 sevens are 56. So you have to write 8 as quotient and 56 below the dividend. So 56 minus 56, 0. Now you have to write the quotient and remainder for the sum. So quotient equal to 8 and remainder equal to 0. So 56 divided by 7 equal to 8 or 0. Okay, 8 or 0. No need to write 0 as your answer means. Simply leave it as 8 only. Okay. Then I hope you are all understand. This is the method of doing division. Today home assignment. Do the sums in self practice. 6E, 1, 2, 5th sum and 6F. Second, third and fourth sum. Thank you, children. Thank you all.